fresh blackboard here. Talk about angles and standard position. There'll be a stream of quick little videos. Let's get right to it. From the beginning, that I could be using to symbolize an angle. This is an angle. You know, the angle measurements in between there, right? Sometimes I use the word or the symbol that instead of angle. It's a good shortcut. But what are we actually talking about? Usually you have an angle, you have an arm and a measurement in between, okay? It can be measured in radians or it can be measured in degrees. That's fine. What we're going to look at is putting this measurement on a Cartesian plane, okay? What that means is this is like a grid, like this is our x or our y and our x axis here, okay? First of all, if you have any angle, we're going to go through some terminology here, okay? If you have an angle where one angle is one of the arms is flat, you have the I gotta look at my notes here. Okay, you have two arms. You have the initial arm, and then you have the terminal arm. Okay, what do I mean by this? Okay, well, the initial arm is the name of the arm when it's always flat. Okay, so perfectly horizontal, but it's also always pointing right. Okay, and always centered at zero. Well, that's its axis point. Okay, that's called the initial arm. Don't ever forget. Okay. What happens then is we take the other arm, it starts behind it like this, and we move, right? With sound effects. And this, wherever it stops, I mean, this is called the terminal arm. Wherever it stops, there will be a point. Let me get back here, okay? On the circle here, here's our initial arm. Because it's on the x-axis, it's flat, and it's points right. We go up like this. This is our terminal arm here, and it'll connect the circle at some kind of point, right? We'll call that point P, okay? It's some point P where the terminal arm connects with the circle, okay? Now remember that anywhere that anything connects with the circle, it's a distance of the radius, okay? Now, what did I want to go on about that? Oh, yes, okay. So there's a point here. This is the terminal arm. There's something called coterminal angles. I'll just briefly touch on that. I think it'll come up later. Coterminal angles are any angle that this point will be connected with again. So for example, if this was a 45 degree angle, better yet, so I can think about this. If this was a 10 degree angle, okay? And this is point P, okay? Our angle of theta equals 10 degrees, and the angle 360 plus 10, these angles are, okay, that's 370. 10 degrees and 370 degrees are coterminal. Why? Because the when you rotate the angle, the terminal arm around, it gets all the way around, it connects back with point PXY. I could go around again. 360, 720, 10 more degrees, 730. So 730 degrees is also coterminal to 370 and 10, okay? That's just a little note on coterminal, but we'll get into the next videos and they'll explain a little more.